polynomials. Let us try to understand what are the topics that we are going to cover in this chapter. So your first topic is algebraic expressions and polynomials, then types of polynomials, polynomials in one variable, value of a polynomial, zero of a polynomial, remainder theorem, factor theorem, and algebraic identities. So let us move on to the first topic, that is algebraic expressions. So what are algebraic expressions? Here is the definition. Expressions which consists of constant and variable is called as an algebraic expression. First of all, we need to understand what is the meaning of this constant and what is the meaning of this variable. So let us concentrate on constant and variable first. So here it is. Let me first of all tell you what is the meaning of this constant. Now constants are some things whose value cannot be changed. All numbers are constant. That is, you can say all real numbers are constant. So all real numbers are constant. I'll tell you why. There is an example of constant over here. Look at the first example. What is this number called as? This number is called as 2. So I can say this number is 2. So this number is 2. Can I call this number as 5? No. Can I call this number as 10? No. Can I call this number as 20? No. Why? Because its value is fixed. This number has a fixed value and that value is 2. Similarly, if I move on to the next example, what is this number called as? This number is called as 3. Can I call this number as 10? No. Can I call this number as 20? No. Again, its value is fixed. That is, this has to be called as 3. Similarly, the next number is minus 3. The next number is 2 by 6. So all these numbers have a fixed value. They have their independent fixed value. We cannot change it. Therefore, they are said to be constants. And therefore, we say that all numbers come in the category of constants. Now, let us move on to variables. So here it is. So what are variables? Variables are something that can change its value. That means it is exactly opposite of the constant. All alphabets are variables. We are already aware of what an alphabet is. Alphabets are all from A to Z. So all these alphabets are said to be variables. I'll give you a simple example why all alphabets are variables. This is the first example over here. X plus 3 is equal to 5. Now, can you guess the value of x in this example? What can be this value of x? Which number plus 3 will give you 5? It is very easy. The answer is 2. We can say that in this example, x is equal to 2. Why? Because 2 plus 3 will give me 5. 2 plus 3 will give me 5. In the second example, again there is x over here. X plus 4 is equal to 10. So what is the value of x in this example? We know that the value of x is 6 in this example. Why? Because 6 plus 4 will give me 10. Now if you observe properly, in both the examples, the variable x was used. But is the value of x same in both the examples? No. The value of x in the first example is 2, whereas the value of x in the second example is 6. So we say that the value of x differs depending upon the equation. If I create one more equation over here, say for example x plus 1 is equal to 5. Now what will be the value of x in this case? In this case, the value of this x will be 4. Because 4 plus 1 will give me 5. Now again, 4 plus 1 is 5. Here the value of x is 4. In the previous two examples, the value of x was 6 and 2. Therefore, we can say that x is same. X is the variable. But the value of variable in each expression is changing. The value of x in the first example is 2. The value of x in the second example is 6. And the value of x in the next example is 4. Therefore, we say that the variable can change its value. It can change its value. So all these alphabets are said to be variables because they don't have any fixed value.